Welcome back to BlueHens.com. Ross Schwartzberg here with Delaware head coach Tina Martin. Blue Hens victorious tonight, 76-63 over Old Dominion. Coach, got to get the elephant out of the room here. Win number 299. Talk about what's coming up here against Georgia State, the special season that this comes in with a team, you know, top 15 in the country, and the support of the community here, another packed house here at the Bob tonight.
You know, there really aren't words to describe, like, the fans and what's going on and what's happening right now here at this university with women's basketball. I mean, it's exciting. It's something that I would have never dreamt, and certainly we are living a dream right now. So this is a great thing. The 299, I keep saying to all the reporters, you know, it's the elephant in the room, but that doesn't really bother me. I just want to say thank you to all the players and the coaches. I've been very, very blessed and very fortunate, and I'm very grateful to the players that I've had here and also my coaching staff. Because you can't win games by yourself. I say that all the time, no matter if it's players or coaches. You need everybody to contribute and to do their job and to do it well. And I've just been very, very blessed. So going to Georgia State, you know, it's something, it's a number. But eventually it'll be over and we'll move on. And, you know, we've got six conference games left. And that's really where my focus is right now. You know, certainly 300 will bring a smile to my face and hopefully to all the coaches who have helped and all the players who have played here. But then it's over and we move on. So, you know, that's pretty much how I look at it right now. But it's a nice number to think about. As far as what happened tonight, I think the team played very well the first probably 28, 30 minutes of the game. And then, we lost our focus a little bit. You know, we were able to get the double-digit win, so I was happy about that. And we're in a grind right now. You know, it's February, and we're trying to win basketball games and position ourselves as best as we can.
And with Old Dominion playing that zone, Elena got a lot of double-team, triple-team looks there. Mm-hmm. Still finished with 27 points tonight. Talk about her performance.
Well, you know, Elena can do a little bit of everything, as you know, and we try to get her the ball in different spots on the floor and give her opportunities to get good looks at the basket. And, you know, she was hitting some outside jumpers, and then we got her inside a little bit. And then that opens up, when they're going to crowd that and play that box and one and hang all over, that opens up rebounding lanes. And I thought that we rebounded the ball pretty well tonight, got on the boards and had an advantage there. And, you know, that's good to see. I thought Danielle Parker kept a lot of balls alive. Lauren Carra shot the three well, so that kind of made him spread out a little bit as we went along. And really it was just the last 8 minutes where we had to take care of the ball and continue to attack the pressure instead of getting a little bit complacent with it. So,
and quick thoughts on Lauren Carra's performance tonight. 18 points, 3 steals, that great block there at the end of the game. She was a big key performer for you tonight.
You know, Lauren's done a little bit of everything for us this year. She's hit the three. She goes to the basket now with confidence, which that's really shown growth in her game. And then she always guards the best opponent's guard. I always make that assignment. And, you know, she's just a tough kid. And I think it's great to see how much confidence now she's playing with, and rightfully so, because she's really stepped up these last 5 or 6 games. And she shut down whoever we wanted to on the defensive end. And now she's hitting threes and going to the basket strong. So just really happy and fortunate to coach her, and you know, I just want to keep her playing the way she is right now because she's playing very well.
Thanks again, Coach. 299 tonight, hopefully 300 against Georgia State this coming weekend. Speaking of Lauren Carra, she's standing alongside Jimmy Smith.
Thanks, Ross, here with Lauren Carra. Lauren, it was a great night for you tonight. Obviously, the story is always Elena. She got held in check, but you stepped up big time with the 22 points. But let's forget all that. On the defensive side right there at the end of the basketball game, 6 seconds left, a monstrous block. You're not necessarily known for something like that, but you just told me that felt really good. Take us through that play.
I mean, we were in three-point defense, so we were switching all the screens, and she just happened to turn the corner, and I helped Akima. Either it was Akima or True, and either it was going to be a foul or a block. So either I was going to be sent to the bench or that was going to go into the stands. So I got lucky on that one, to say the least.
But your game is kind of taken a dynamic stance. You are a huge threat from three, but now you're a threat from three is giving you the ability to drive to the basket. Which do you prefer, the three ball or going to the hoop?
I think now going to the hoop a lot, because a lot of teams are playing me for the three and they're running out at me. So that gives me the opportunity to get to the basket or to find someone open, because they're going to collapse now. So, I mean, to be able to get to the basket to score or to dish off and get someone else a basket, that's what I would rather do.
Things keep moving along for you guys. 21 wins on the season now, 12-0 undefeated in the CAA. But another landmark's coming up for the program, for the university and everything. I heard you talking about it over there with the radio. 300 wins for head coach Tina Martin is an incredible feat. Talk about, as a program and as a group of girls, a family, what that would mean to get Boss Lady the win.
I mean, that would be unbelievable for her, especially this year with all the attention we have, all the accomplishments we've already gone through. I mean, for her to get it this year would be great for all the work she's put in and for the program that she's developed over the last I'm not sure how many years she's been here, but that would be an unbelievable thing for her.
Now, it requires a tough road trip to Atlanta. It's one of the further ones you'll take, and a Georgia State team that we may run into again in the tournament. Who knows? So what do you know, and how are you preparing for such a long bus ride?
Coach Martin just told us in the locker room, they're a pressing team. So we need to work on our defense because we lost the lead there in the second half when Old Dominion pressed. So we need to go into practice tomorrow and really work on that to go down there to Georgia State and hopefully pull out a win.
All right, Lauren, thank you and congratulations.
Thank you.
Lauren finishes with 18 points, 4 rebounds, and that one really loud block. The Hens win it 76-63, move to 12-0 unscathed in the CAA. On Sunday, they head to Atlanta to take on Georgia State at 2 o'clock. For information about that one, visit BlueHens.com. For Ross Schwarzberg, head coach Tina Martin, and Lauren Carra, I'm Jimmy Smith. Thanks for clicking on BlueHens.com.